This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Srinivasan. There are species on the planet today that may not be here next week or next month. And that's where an interesting photo project called the Biodiversity Project comes in. Photographer Joel Sartore is helping us see animals in a way that we might not have seen them before. He joins us now. He's a contributing photographer to National Geographic. Thanks for being with us.
My pleasure.
So there are a lot of nature photographs out there. There are a lot of nature photographers, but very few times have I ever seen animals in such striking black and white backgrounds. For someone who's not familiar with it, how are you doing this? Are you taking a photo studio into zoos with you as you go around the world?
I am. And into the wild sometimes too. You know, I make my living working for National Geographic magazine. I've done so for 21 years or so as a contributing photographer, freelance actually. But whenever I get the chance, I take these backgrounds, these studio backgrounds, and many times studio lighting with me, and I'll work with zoos or captive organizations, you know, aquariums, anybody who's got animals captive, and talk to them and say, which animals do you think would tolerate this portrait process? Which would actually enjoy the process? Which wouldn't run away or be too stressed out? And we work up lists, and you know, I've been doing this for 6 years and I've got almost 2,000 species now. I'm going to try to do every species that's captive in U.S. zoos and aquariums if I can. That's 6,000. So I'm about a third of the way there. I figure another 10 or 12 years I might get there.
Okay, so let's talk about some of the more interesting and possibly close to extinct animals that you've taken photographs of.
Oh, sure.
You said that there's a tree frog that there's only one of them left?
Right, yeah. It's Rab's fringe-limbed tree frog. There was one at Zoo Atlanta and one at the Atlanta Botanical Gardens. And just a few days ago, they had to euthanize the one at Zoo Atlanta, and I'd photographed that one. So now there's one male left. They don't believe there are any in the wild due to a fungus that spread through the forests that's spreading right now around the world. So this is another passenger pigeon, if you will. It's another species that's been being lost, and we probably had something to do with it.
And from something so small as a tree frog, let's go to this Sumatran rhino.
Right, that's an animal that's very big and charismatic. It's thought to be one of our oldest living mammals. It's hairy still, or woolly, from the last time the earth was cold. And it's down to 9 in captivity, about 150 in the wild. And things don't look good. I mean, there's always hope. There is hope. They could get more into the breeding population. They could find more Rab's tree frogs somewhere. But, you know, for a lot of these species, zoos are arcs. They're what are going to carry these species going forward, and they cannot save everything. People really need to wake up and realize that our impact on the planet matters and try to figure out a way to be more gentle to the planet, really.
And then you've got the Arctic ground squirrels here. Why are these guys important?
Oh, that's an interesting one. It's an Arctic rodent that hibernates 8 months a year. And so NASA is studying these animals to see how they do it without kidney damage, for example. They also super cool their blood below freezing, another first for a mammal that we know of, and they can heal traumatic brain injury while they sleep. They can suffer a terrible wound to their brain while they're hibernating and wake up a few months later just fine. And so the medical community is really fascinated by this animal, thinking it would have long-term benefit to us to figure out how it does it.
So we could take trips to Mars and basically just kind of wake up there after a long, long, long nap.
That's right, if we could figure it out. And the important thing to remember is half of all biodiversity, if we keep going the way we are, half of all biodiversity will be lost by the turn of the next century. And so all these pictures in the Biodiversity Project are designed to just, number one, be an archive to show the world what we had. These animals are all depicted in life, looking good on black and white backgrounds. That gives a mouse as much visual importance and weight as a polar bear, for example. But it's to get people to actually care. Looking these animals in the eye, I think, is a good way of getting people to stop and think about all that's at stake, all that we're losing, and gets them into the tent of conservation, and we can begin a bigger or a broader dialogue with people as far as how we live and how we spend our money actually impacts species all around the world.
All right, Joel Sartore with the Biodiversity Project, thanks so much for your time.
Thank you.
This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Srinivasan. Stay with us.